प्रणाम टू एवरीवन, रेस्पेक्टेड चेयरपर्सन एंड ऑल्सो द अदर मेंबर्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग माय टॉपिक आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक्स the organizing committee, the department of yogic arts and science, and specially to Dr. Samiran Mandal for inviting me and giving me a chance to share my ideas with you all. I would also like to thank you everybody, all the delegates, all the participants who are with me now. So my topic, which is based on my doctoral study and UGC research project, is the effect of selected yogic practices on coronary artery disease. As you know that coronary artery disease is a such kind of disease, the maximum number of deaths throughout the world is under his belt. Even today, despite tremendous development in the field of allopathic medical science, medical research, and also in the field of drugs, medicine, still the number of deaths is not decreasing. That's why it is very serious kind of problem. You all know that coronary artery disease is caused by the any kind of block inside the coronary artery, which reduces the flow of blood in a particular part of heart, so the heart can't function properly. So what will be the effect of yogic science? As you know that yoga is a traditional Indian knowledge, which is related to not only our physical body, but also with our total personality. So, if there is any effects of yogic practices on this particular field, so to understand, to know, to observe all these things, we conducted the study. We selected 60 subjects from different hospitals and out of 60, 47 were male and 13 were female. The average age was 55, ranging from 37 years to 68 years. So, at first, we have measured the condition of the patients. All the patients, they are taking drug therapy under the supervision of medical experts. So we measured their blood pressure, their cholesterol level, their cholesterol and HDL ratio, and also their efficiency of circulation inside the body through the arteries by Doppler test. At first, we divided all the subjects in three groups, two experimental groups and one control group. 20 subjects in each group. The first group, group A, the name was Subhashan Meditation Group. The group B, that is also experimental group, named Combined Yoga Group. And group C, naturally, it was control group. Before starting the program, we measured their blood pressure, total cholesterol count, cholesterol HDL ratio, and most importantly, the ABPI score through Doppler test. And then we introduce a yogic program for the experimental group. Especially for group A, only Savasana and meditation. And group B, that is combined yoga group, they practiced some asanas, pranayam, and Savasana meditation. In combined yoga group, the duration of Savasana meditation was short, but in only Savasana meditation group, the duration of Savasana and meditation was long. The control group, they are not given any kind of intervention with yoga. So the duration of the experiment was 4 months. They practiced, the experimental group practiced 5 days a week up to 4 months. And after 4 months, again we test, post-test, their blood pressure, systolic and diastolic, their total cholesterol count, the cholesterol and HDL ratio, and also the ABPI score of the patients. The data was analyzed using t-test and analysis of variance. The level of significance was set at 5% level of confidence. The result showed that in case of systolic blood pressure, the T value of 7.835 for group A, T value 8.701 for group B was statistically significant. In case of control group, showed no significant mean difference compared to the critical differences. In respect of diastolic blood pressure, the statistical analysis of data revealed that all the true experimental groups showed significant difference, T value 1.896 for group A and T value 10.768 for group B was statistically significant. But for the control group, they revealed no differences at all. the inter-group comparison by post-hoc test showed the maximum mean difference between group A and group B. So, the t values of 8.720 for group A and 7.822 for group B revealed that the difference of mean cholesterol level of the experimental group were significant, and for control group it was insignificant. As you know, that the blood cholesterol level is a very important factor for coronary artery disease. But the cholesterol level and the ratio in between cholesterol and HDL is more important. So, in respect of cholesterol HDL ratio in blood, t values of 9.047 for group A and 7.620 for group B revealed that the difference in mean cholesterol HDL ratio of experimental groups were significant, and for control group it was insignificant. The analysis of variance indicates that group B had the highest significant difference. The inter-group comparison by post-hoc test showed the significant mean difference between group A and group B. So, as you know, that till today there is no such drugs to increase the HDL level in our blood. But many research works showed that yogic practices is proved very effective to increase HDL level of the blood. As your HDL increase, the chances of coronary disease is reduced. Even some physical exercise is also very helpful to improve the HDL level in the blood. Most importantly, in case of ABPI score, there was no such significant difference in the patients in experimental group. We showed very little increase in the mean value of the experimental group, but we can't say the score was statistically significant. So, it is very important to use the yogic practices in case of coronary artery disease. I must say that the yogic practice is not only few words. For the combined yoga group, we practiced some asanas, some pranayams and savasana meditation. But as you know, the traditional technique of yoga is completely different. There are so many ways of practicing asanas or pranayamas or meditation. So we have followed, for savasana, we have followed the progressive relaxation technique. And for meditation, we followed the traditional technique of Maharshi Patanjali. For asanas, very interestingly, we are not following the technique of like some stretching exercise. We have followed the technique of Maharshi Patanjali, that is Ananta Samapattibhyam. Prayatna Saithilya Ananta Samapattibhyam. That means the asanas, not only some stretching of the muscles or bending the bodies forward or backward, but it's a completely psychosomatic practice which includes your body, your mind, your total personality, so that you can feel a calmness, coolness and relaxation deep inside you while practicing asanas. So if you are practicing asanas and the end result is stress, then you are doing some mistakes. So we followed the technique of Maharshi Patanjali, Prayatna Saithilya, the effortless, and Ananta Samapatti. After going to the final position of the asanas, you should focus your mind on a particular object which is Ananta, infinite. Then only you can enjoy the benefits of traditional asanas properly. So I think this is sufficient. So in my study, we studied the systolic blood pressure, diastolic blood pressure, cholesterol level, cholesterol HDL ratio, and ABPI score. In systolic, diastolic, cholesterol level, and cholesterol HDL ratio, the combined yoga group showed maximum amount of increase. Whereas in control group, there was no such difference. So again, I want to thanks you everybody, and again to Dr. Samiran Mandal for giving me an opportunity to share my ideas with you. And why the ABPI score is not significant? It may need some more times, or it may possible that we should add some different yogic practices also. So you can go further study with these parameters. So again, I want to thank you all, and pranam.